Hi people, welcome to Chess24/7 and you are encountering another online chess video. And in today's game I will be showing you how to keep your opponent busy and not let him castle. And it's a really terrific game. It lasted for 22 moves, but it's a really cool game where the white side was just sacrificing everything so that he could get the white black king. And this game is quite old. This game took place in 1958 in Berlin, Germany. And with the white pieces we have Wolfgang, and with the black pieces we have Zeitemann. So let's get started. Okay, so the game starts with e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, bishop c4, bishop c5, and we have Cuco Piano, white castles, knight f6. And now if you look at the situation, because white always starts the game, he has an advantage, and that advantage is that he is slightly ahead in development. In this case, he has castled up his king, and from here on white will try to keep the black king in the center of the board if possible. So he starts with d4, bishop takes d4, knight takes d4, knight takes d4, f4, and with all these moves white has lost a piece, but he has kept black's pieces busy and has not allowed white to castle. And with f4, if e5 takes f4, queen takes e4, so knight c6, bishop takes f7, check. In the game, king f8 was played, but let's have a look. If after bishop takes f7, king takes f7, then f takes e5, if knight takes e5, queen d5, check. The queen cannot be captured by this knight because this knight is in a pin by the rook. So king f8 and queen takes e5. And now white is down by one single pawn, but if you look at the situation, the black king cannot castle and he will have hard time bringing his h8 rook into the game, and will have, and the main problem is that the f file is completely open and is dominated by this rook on f1. So that's why after bishop takes f7, king f8 was played. After that, f takes e5, knight takes e5. Now bishop backs to b3, d6, providing some scope to this white bishop on this diagonal. Bishop g5 pinning the knight to the queen, and it's already pinned to the king, so it's in a dual pin now. Bishop g4 hitting the queen, queen d2 sidestepping the attack, king e7, and this is a dubious move because now he's putting himself in his knight in an absolute pin. Queen f4, rook f8, h3 hitting the bishop, bishop d7, knight c3, looking for the very good square on d5 that comes with check. C6 deals with the d5 square, rook a to d1, h6, and here white makes a stunning move, rook takes d6. In the game, queen b6 check was played, but let's have a look what will happen if king takes d6, then queen e5 check, sacrificing yet another piece, king takes e5, bishop f4 check, king d4, these are the only moves available, rook d1 check, king c5, Bishop e3, king b4, rook d4, king c5, king rook d5, king b4, and a3 would be mate. That's really just genius of Wolfgang, looking so much deep into the game. So after rook takes d6, there's another move possible, h takes g5, hitting the queen, then Queen takes e5 check, the only move is bishop e6, and then queen takes e6 mate. So after rook takes b6, black, instead of capturing the rook, played queen b6 check, king h1, now king takes d6, but this is bad because queen takes e5, sacrificing the queen once again, king takes e5, bishop f4, king d4, rook d1, king c5, and bishop d6 mate. Well, I don't need to say anything much about this game because we can clearly see that although white is down by a whole queen and pawn, but the problem is that his king got mated in the process, and it's a really good example of how to keep your opponent busy and not let him cast in. And I think it's a tremendous example of chess creativity and the geniusness of chess players. And yeah, that's it for this video, and I hope you liked this video, and if you did, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and see you in my next video. Till then, take care, ta-ra, goodbye, good day.